Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the new Amy Schumer comedy, I Feel Pretty. By the way, also stars a few folks who have seen movies at Harkins Theaters, A.D. Bryant and Busy Phillips, who both grew up in Scottsdale and Phoenix, the Harkins headquarters. And Busy's husband co-wrote and directed this movie. Great messaging. Everyone needs a little bit of confidence, and we've got some tips on how to get it. Take a look.
I know you don't recognize me.
That's me.
You guys, it's me. Renee.
I love the message that at the end of the day, it's really an attitude change.
Yeah.
What is something that hasn't changed at all, but your attitude about it has totally changed, so you see this thing in a whole new light because of your attitude change?
That's a great question. Physical insecurities, things like when I first was in the public eye, it was like I was told, like, you either have to gain a lot of weight and be the funny friend or lose a lot of weight and be the lead. And people are just telling you, like, it's a fact. And I just kind of believed them. I was like a size 4 or 2 or something. Like, I was, and I was still getting flack for that. So I was like, oh, well, cool. Well, I'm just going to take myself out of the running. You know, I'm going to just. I'm not gonna be hungry. I chose to live my life and have fun and drink when I want and, you know, also be healthy. I'm not like crazy, but I made that was a choice I had the luxury of making.
I was gonna answer tomatoes, by the way. I used to hate them. Just an attitude shift. How about you? Attitude shift?
I should have just said tomatoes.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think for like probably most people, there's an attitude about their own physicality and what they think they look like. And you know, a lot of people that see this movie and feel better about themselves, it won't be 100%. They'll have to constantly remind themselves that, you know, it's you. You decide your own value and your own worth. Yeah, I have down days where maybe I'm not too crazy about myself, but we put ourselves on stage in front of strangers most nights out of the week. So eventually you get to a point where you no longer look at it and go, oh, I hope these people like me. You go up and you say, oh, I'm about to make these people laugh, and I know exactly why.
I need you to go to corporate.
No, I can't go there.
Repeat after me.
I always get nervous at these junket interviews still, and I've been doing it for a long time, but I learned something in your movie.
I am brave.
I am brave.
I am blonde.
I am blonde.
And I got this.
I'm brave. I'm blonde. And I got this.
And you got this.
Yeah.
That was an Adrian Martinez, that actor. That was an improvised moment. So we can thank him for that.
I didn't know that. That's cool.
Is there something that you kind of say in your mind that does get you fired up in moments of self-doubt?
I look at myself in the mirror and I say, you got this, you know?
Right.
I think this is the package I came in, and I'm not planning on any surgeries. Work with this.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It's enough. You're enough.
I look in the mirror and I say, there's always surgeries. If it doesn't work today, surgery tomorrow.
Good.
And I go right out into the world.
Great message.
I have a crazy idea. Let's be honest for a minute.
Have you had those moments where you stand in front of the mirror and you're like, ugh?
Of course. Yeah. Yes.
Recently, or was this back in
high
school?
This morning. My skirt didn't close that my stylist had sent me. Because, I mean, and I was like, oh, God, really? I've only been in New York 4 days. I mean, I did eat pizza last night, but come on.
Are you shopping for a gift?
Kind of browsing for me.
So sizing is a little limited here in the store, but you could probably find your size online.
When was the last time you experienced a true moment of self-doubt?
I'd say in this business, it's probably more often than you want it to be, but you sort of grow out of it and learn to be more confident. I can't say anything specifically, but I've definitely had times going on stage to do stand-up and was just like nervous about my act, nervous about the crowd, nervous about the connection we might have, and you doubt yourself, and then you usually come off stage and you're like, that was the most fun show I've ever done.
Right. Yeah, the moments you're feeling the worst before you perform usually wind up being the best.
Does it happen still to you, though? I know you've talked about this is a work in progress.
Totally. Yeah. Constant. It's a never-ending journey. I think I have a really good baseline where if I have my period, if I feel like garbage, I'm gonna feel bad. But I feel like I really know who I am now. And yeah, nobody can really mess with that.
What makes you feel pretty?
Being comfortable, having my voice heard, being with friends, you know?
I guess being comfortable and relaxed and being around people that I love and just feeling good.
I feel prettiest when I feel most comfortable. But sometimes that does mean like being dressed up, and sometimes that means like working out and sweating and,
you know, getting the endorphins going.
The pressure of your husband having co-written this and now directing this, were you consulted in the writing process at all?
Consulted is an interesting word. We're married, and we discuss everything and talk about a lot. We're constantly in contact. I did talk to him and Abby about the script as they were writing it. I read early drafts. I was involved when they were getting it financed and with Amy, and so I have known about it. I'm basically like a producer on the movie. That's what I'm gonna
say. Actually, I read the whole thing.
I mean, I pretty much did it myself.
You hit your head pretty hard.
Your character's kind of funny because we know literally nothing about her.
That's me? Yeah, is that okay?
We know she works at SoulCycle.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's it.
Did you create kind of a fun, like, how did she get there? What's her story?
No.
I did not, no. I guess, you know, maybe her mom was like a jazzercise instructor, and she was like, I want to do that one day. And so she went to SoulCycle because that's like really trendy right now. One day she's going to open up her own version of an exercise trend that'll probably involve headstands.
What's up, Soho? You ready for this?
Yeah, I love SoulCycle, and actually, like, that is some, it is something that's funny that's from Mark in my real life, which is that I got him into SoulCycling, and he's, like, totally addicted to it. And actually, the woman that plays Luna, the instructor, is like our real life SoulCycle instructor in Los Angeles, Angela Davis.
Today you're gonna see what you've always wanted to be. Change your mind, change your life.
Also, she's no joke. She's the class that Beyonce and Jay-Z go to, and Usher, and like, it's like her class is for real. So
she's legit.
She's very legit. So that was like a little bit of our personal life when they were trying to break the story of how the Renee character has this accident. Mark's like, SoulCycle. It's gotta be in SoulCycle. She falls in SoulCycle.
I've done one SoulCycle class. I don't understand why you have to be so close to everybody to bite.
Yeah, it's not a good environment if you value personal space.
No offense, SoulCycle. Like, clearly people are, the before and after photos are great.
Yeah.
But you're right there.
Contact.
And you can't like leave without it being a big scene.
You can't without rush, like bumping into people.
No, you need like a headlamp to get out of there. It's so dark. To become a miner.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film I Feel Pretty. That is my new mantra. I'm brave, I'm blonde, and I got this. You too can have a mantra, blonde or not. Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And we will see you at the movies.